Welcome to the Political Ferret Show. New content will be uploaded every Wednesday and Sunday. This video was financed by my Patreons. Thank you for making the change possible. This video might start a little bit weird, but it will make sense in the end, so stay with me. So, if I show you this figure, how large is its perimeter? Well, it is infinite. And, well, that sounds strange, so let's go to something that is a bit less confusing. So, what do you think is the surface area of one of these little balls? Well, it is approximately as large as a soccer field. So, I hear you say, what? How can this be? So, let's dive into that, shall we? If we take this square, we know that its perimeter is something in the line of that. We have in the middle, the white thing is the volume and the red is the perimeter around that. So, we do this now on the sides to remember that. Now, we want to increase the surface area, but we do not want to increase the volume. What do? Well, we cut it through. And if you cut it through, we have now some areas that were before not surface areas, but they are now. And because this was quite funny and I like this sword, we do it again. And now we have even more surface area. This means that we have additionally to this old red surface area a new green surface area, which means that we, with just two cuts, did de facto double the surface area. And this is how these little balls and so on function. They have a lot of craters in it, and craters in the craters, and craters in the craters, so this makes a real giant surface area. So what is a real life application for that? Well, on your grill, when your coal does not burn, stomp it, make it a little bit smaller, then you have a bigger surface area, a higher reaction to the fire, and it will burn faster. But let's go into a little bit more abstract things. What about this coastline? What if I told you that when I send out two troops who will measure this coastline, they will come up with very, very different results? Because the Spanish and French did that, and they came up with a difference of a factor of two, so one measured double the length of this line than the other. So how can this be? Let's take this as an example, and if you see a bed in there, visit a psychologist. So the first group, the blue group, that's the lazy group, they say, well, that's the surface area, that's good enough. But then comes the red one, and the red are very precise, and they measure it like this. And if you add up the lines, you will see that the red line is approximately double the length of the blue line. But on the other hand, the blue team did the work in more or less a tenth of the time, because they just said, well, it's roughly that's good enough. The thing is, also the red is not really, really right. When you go on a coastline, you can measure deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. There are always some things where you can measure deeper inside, and you will get always a longer result. So what has this to do with politics? What is the political implication? Well, it is something that I would call the expert trap. You have now something you are concerned with, some topic, whatever it is, and then you cut it, and you cut it, and you cut it, and you cut it, and you go deeper and deeper, and you produce ever more surface area, ever more stuff to watch it. But there is not more volume. You already have the volume more or less dissected. You understand the topic already. The thing is, you go only deeper and deeper and deeper into a detail of a detail of a detail of a detail, but there is no substance left. You have it already. I mean, you can double the surface by two steps, by cut it in the one direction, by cut it in the other direction. You are deep enough to understand way more than all other people who just observe this thing from abroad. And so dissecting it two times, it's enough. But people tend to do this 1,000 times. And when you do that, you miss that there are other topics around, and a lot of topics around. So this is something that you might think of when you cut even deeper. When you have some thematic, some topic that you really, really like, and you say, I go even deeper. At some point, nobody cares. And that's the thing, and you shouldn't care, because there's not a lot to gain anymore. So what I want to say with that is, go out of your comfort zone and tackle some topics that you do not understand yet, on a broader scale. It is very tempting to stay in a topic that you already know and go deeper and deeper and deeper and with ever more results of ever more details, but it makes not a lot of sense at some point. And if I sparked your interest in fractals, that was what we have seen in the beginning with the infinite surface areas and so on, you can Google this stuff and watch some articles, or you can try to download Vision of Chaos and play around with these things. A quite easy program, it's free to download, and no, I don't get money from them, I just really like this program. So for me this was one of the points where I really started to love mathematics. So that's about it from me. Try to find other stuff, try to cut into other stuff that you don't understand, and you will pretty fast become an ARC expert from that. Don't stay all too long with topics that you know already very, very well, and don't fall into this expert trap of digging deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper and producing more and more and more surface area with the same volume that is already there until you end up on an atomic nuclear level where there is, where you know everything about absolutely nothing. That's important, don't fall in this expert trap. So, that's for me. Thanks for listening, like, share and subscribe, and have a wonderful day.